is on its side, and it's on a few dollies. And the dollies have ball bearings on it. And this entire rocket, which weighs, I think, fully loaded, weighs 30 tons. With the dollies and the rails on the ground, four people can move it. I mean, that's, look, if you look around the room, you won't see much. It's an incredibly simple operation. You've got two overhead 40-ton cranes, well, the 40 together, two 20s. The rocket weighs 30 tons when it's all done. On the ground, it can be moved by four people, easily pushing it, no need to motorize it. When it comes to lifting it up, to putting it on the dollies, the rail car that would actually move it, it's actually the mobile launch pad itself, that's when we would use the cranes. But the advantage as well of a horizontal integration is, as you can all see, it's all within easy reach. You just need to, you can see a ladder down the end of the way. Everyone works on ladders. You also notice of two wheels. There's a wheel on the other side. There's a ring around the rocket. And when the wheels turn, it's like a chicken rotisserie. The rocket will turn. So if there's a part that you need to reach at the top of the rocket and it's out of reach, the wheels will turn, the rocket will move, and everything becomes accessible. Behind me, what you can just see the bells of, and the reason are, is there's export control regulations known as ITAR. They are notoriously difficult, so we can't show you much of the plumbing. But these are engines. These are clean sheet design engine. This is our engine.
Clean sheet.
Clean sheet means that it doesn't, like a lot of the rockets that you have now, would propose or either use bits of engine families that existed before them. So they have a lot of heritage technology and therefore heritage infrastructure and cost. We design the engine, like all parts of the Falcon 9 and the Dragon, completely with the notion that we were going to look at cost as part of reliability and safety from the outset. So a clean sheet meant that there was nothing. We started with a clean sheet of paper to design the engine. And what you have is you've got nine engines. They're 3x3, which is really interesting because if you've seen the Falcon launches, you see that the contrail is really interesting. It's square because of that configuration, where a lot of the other contrails and the flames coming off have a cylindrical look. This is a square look. Anyway, each engine has got about 100,000 pounds of thrust. There's a new engine in development, which is the Merlin 1D. Which will have about 125 and 140 pounds of thrust. The rocket's put together, Dragon's integrated,
right.
The rocket's ready to go. It weighs about 30 tons.
Okay.
That rocket then is, we've got two cranes above, each carrying 20 tons.
Okay.
The rocket then is lifted off of the dollies that they're now on. Transporter is taken out from the pad, which is let down, it's horizontal, it's driven in, the rocket is then lowered onto the transporter,
okay,
bolted on, and driven out and put vertical. Entire process, from lowering it down to getting it standing up is less than an hour, and we're working to improve those times. What you're looking at is a 110,000 gallon LOX sphere, it's a tank.
Okay.
It holds liquid oxygen. It was actually the Apollo 1 liquid oxygen tank. Part of the deal about, as I constantly talk about, the need to be simple and affordable.
Right.
We bought this from NASA for a dollar over scrap. It's hard to come by tanks that big.
And you got it for a dollar over scrap value?
Dollar over scrap value.
Well, today we're taking you to Space Launch Complex 40 at Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. As you can see, we've been given a behind-the-scenes tour. It's been one of the most amazing, eye-opening experiences of this small little reporter's life. We want to thank SpaceX. We want to thank Bobby Block for taking us on this tour and showing us how everything works. He's walked us through all the processes of horizontal integration and why it's important. But we also want to take the time to make sure that you follow SpaceX on Twitter at their account, at SpaceXer, and that's spelled in the at symbol, SpaceXER. So check them out, follow them, follow all the cool information and things they got going on. Go SpaceX.